Hey everybody, today I wanted to talk about one of the foundational things in SQL, which is the joins. Okay, Snowflake provides powerful joins, and we're going to look into two specific joins. Okay, the inner joins and the left join. Between these two joins, 95% of industry related queries can be answered. Okay, what's an inner join? It joins table A and table B, and it displays only the common columns. Okay, a left join has its anchor on the left table, in this case it's A, and shows everything on table A and only matching rows from table B on this particular join. Okay, the right join is just the opposite of the left join, and it's going to show you all data from table B and only the matching columns from table A. Okay, with that, let's go to our Google Sheets. So we have a regular orders table with order ID, order value and delivery zip code. We have the city table with the zip code and city. If you see, you know, the city information from here is missing here. Okay, what we're going to do is write SQL query to connect this entire row with city. Okay, so the way we're going to do is we're going to use a delivery zip code from here, connect it to zip code from city table, and we're going to select a city so that, you know, how we would see is we would see data like this. Okay, so this is the goal. So let's go ahead and create these tables. So we go here, and we already have our city table. So what we're going to do is just rename it to locations table, and then copy it to clipboard, go here and paste it here. Okay, I'm going to add the replace function here because there's already a table with the name locations, so that's why I'm going to add replace, so that this table overwrites that table. Okay, so we have locations table done. Now let's take our orders table. So we have totally 16 rows, okay, and one row header. So we go here, we'd say, you know, we want 17 cross 3, okay, and it's going to ask this. So we paste here, we come here, and we would change this into a sales table, and then we'd copy this into clipboard, paste it here. You know, we drew the regular replace, and then run everything. Okay, we have everything inserted. Let's double check by selecting the sales table. We have 16 rows in sales table. We have the same 16 rows. Now let's look at the locations table. We have San Francisco, Cupertino, and Gothenburg. Keep in mind, Chennai is missing. Okay. Also keep in mind, the zip code of Berlin is not found here. Okay. We'll come to the missing part later. So, first, what we want is we want to select everything from the sales table, and we want city to be shown somewhere here, okay, just like how San Francisco was shown here. You know, similarly we'd like to see a city somewhere here. So for that, what we do is select sales table and show me everything from sales star. Okay, sales dot asterisk means show me all the columns from sales chart, okay? And then we're going to come here and say, hey, you know what, join this table. So inner join, join this table with the locations table. Okay, now we've said we're going to join sales table with locations table on what? So inner join locations table on locations table dot zip code is equal to sales table dot delivery zip code. Okay, so locations table zip code, which is here, is equal to orders table's delivery zip code. That's what the join is based on. Okay, and once we do that, you know, our inner join is established. Okay, now all we have to do is take locations table comma, and let's do locations table dot city. Okay, and then let's run this, and you see order 1 149 94107 city. You know, that's all, folks. You know, when you write powerful joins, you know, you can combine two tables and you would see city data right close to order data. Okay, now let's examine the resultant set. Okay, the resultant set only has 12 data. We were expecting 16. What happened is, you know, the Berlin zip code here was not found here. Therefore, what Snowflake did was it only took this and it mapped with the corresponding cities. Okay, so this is what a inner join does. You see, it only takes the matching stuff from both sides and shows. Okay, obviously, you know, you being the sales manager would also want to look into the orders regardless of city information is available or not. In that case, what you do is instead of inner join, you would do a left join. Okay, now if you see, you get all the 16 rows and a lot of null values. You get a lot of null values because they are missing on the city table. Okay, regardless of them missing or present, you still get all the 16 rows. Okay, now let's say you wanted to just flip the script and you just want everything to be based on city table. All you have to do is change the left to right join and then rerun the query. And when you do so, you know, you're restricted to your 12 rows. Okay, so this is your left table and this is your right table. Okay, so between inner join, left join and right join, most of your problems in your work setting should be solved. Okay, hopefully you understood what joins are. Thank you. Hey, I hope you had a educative session from one of our tutorial videos. Just in case, if you're wondering how to get in touch with us, you can always email me at chris@analyze.agency, or you could visit our website, which is analyze.agency. Hit the get in touch button and plug in your details. Who we are a data and analytics consulting services. We worked in all three major cloud platforms, AWS, GCP, and Azure. We ETL data, we analyze data, we warehouse data, and we also include AI in our data. So if you wish to get in touch, please do, and let's have a discovery call. Thank you.